Minister of Power and Energy and Business Development Ravi Karunanayake assures that there will be no power cuts from tonight.
I have given a word to implement it. It is not a lie. We have acted according to a plan while resolving the issue. I have not made this statement because of the vacation. We said that there will be no power cuts from midnight today, which means from tomorrow morning. When I assumed duties, I said that the domestic prices will not increase. I won't change unless we reduce it. The cabinet has granted approval to purchase additional power of 100 megawatts to ensure the uninterrupted supply of power. Accordingly, 34 megawatts of power will be purchased from the Pallikale and Gaul grid substations from Agrico International Project Limited at a cost of 30 rupees and 20 cents per kilowatt. Cabinet approval has been granted to purchase 10 megawatts for the Mahiyangane grid substation at a cost of 30 rupees and 58 cents per kilowatt and 8 megawatts for the Polonnaruwa grid substation at a cost of 30 rupees and 63 cents from Altaka Alternative Solutions Company Limited. 24 megawatts will be purchased from T-Power at a cost of 28 rupees and 43 cents for the Hammanthotta substation. T-Power will also provide 24 megawatts to Horana grid substation at a cost of 28 rupees and 70 cents. Meanwhile, cabinet approval is also granted to appoint a committee headed by Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe to present short, medium and long-term recommendations for an uninterrupted supply of power. The committee comprises of Mangala Samarvira, Ravi Karunanayake, Kabir Hashim and Sagala Ratnayake. What's left to do is providing a permanent solution to this by generating power at a lower cost without burdening the general public. A solution was given at the cabinet meeting in the presence of President and the Prime Minister 2 days ago. It is to construct 6 to 7 new thermal power plants. It will begin before the 30th of June 2019. This program will also include the construction of a number of coal and solar power plants.
This evening on our special report, I'm going to ask you a question and then explain as to why I'm asking you that question as well. Have you heard of a situation where a tender has been awarded to two companies for the same project to be carried out in the same vicinity, in the same location? Have you heard of a situation like that? I'm going to explain this cabinet paper that you see behind me. This is a cabinet paper that has been put forward by the Minister of Power and Energy and Business Development. You heard him speaking a short while ago, Minister Ravi Karunanayake, with regard to the long-term and mid-term plans to overcome this power crisis issue that we are facing currently in the country. Now, if you take a look at the proposals that have been made for cabinet approval, several projects have been listed out here. Some can even question as to whether this could result in excess power in the country as well. But however, the problem gets clear in this location where it has proposed a 300 megawatt power plant in Kerolapitiya and another 300 megawatt power plant in Kerolapitiya. Now, we remember in the past that when this tender was awarded, this tender was marred with controversy when one company who did not receive the tender went and decided to take legal action as well. I beg your pardon. Now, after this has happened, we now see that this has been given to two companies to do the same project, two different projects. Now, I'm going to draw your attention to an article that has been published on Economy Next as well. Sri Lanka decision for two 300 megawatt IPPs in one tender was bipartisan, says Mr. Ravi Karunanayake. If you read this article through, a decision to award 300 megawatt power plant to the first and second bidder in a single tender for an independent power producer was bipartisan. They are, of course, quoting the Minister of Power and Energy. Sri Lanka called for bids for a dual-fuel 300 megawatt power plant in 2016, but the tender had been marred in controversy and corruption allegations. Now, that is a story that I explained to you, where one company decided to go and take legal action against the company that received the tender, and it was a huge mess. Now, what has happened is that two companies, the two bidders, had been awarded the same contract. We come to this particular tweet sent out by a non-cabinet minister of the government itself, Dr. Harsha De Silva. What does he have to say? I am completely against handing out two contracts on one tender, bipartisan or otherwise. Now better take and lower prices, Bhattagoda, a plea to Suren Bhattagoda, Secretary to the Ministry of Power and Energy. President Maithripala Sirisena should appoint commission to investigate entire power sector. It is reeking of corruption. Now, this is not what we are saying. This is being said by a minister, a non-cabinet minister of our government, the present government, Dr. Harsha De Silva. Now comes to the question that I asked you initially. If there is a situation where a tender is being given to two companies to carry out the same project, same specs, into the same location, as a result, giving us two or the same thing, is this a situation where one would see commissions flowing if one person is, for example, giving 10 rupees out of this project that is being carried out, and if the second lowest bidder is granting 12 rupees, is this a bid to take the 2 rupees and also another amount from the second bidder as well, making both these bidders happy at the end of the day? Is this a situation to make sure that everyone who is involved in this situation, in this particular scenario when it comes to the power and energy in our country, be it from the former government, be it from the current government, is this a bid to make everyone happy? The second question that I have for you today. Up to you. We report, you decide.